Hi, my name is Siew May. I'm here. What? Like, what about Asian, but I think I'm beautiful.
I am a conqueror. I am a queen. I am anything that you said I could be. Fly like a phoenix, rise from the ashes. I've got a heart of a lion.
I was born with cerebral palsy, but my identity, I never treat myself disabled.
Cerebral palsy, or CP for short, is a damage to the brain. It can occur when the mother is pregnant, or during delivery, or during the first 5 years of the child's life. So, depending on where the damage is and how severe the damage is, it will affect the child differently. We always say that no two CP children are the same. So it can affect them cognitively, physically, usually it's a combination of both. It can also have other symptoms like vision, hearing, swallowing problems, bowel movements.
I remember when Siew May joined us in Sec 1, she was a 19-year-old girl. And to be in the class seated with the 12 and a half and 13 years old was a bit of a challenge because she was, in a way, older. But Siew May was very proactive. She would make it a point to get to know the juniors. And she would warm up to them much faster than they would warm up to her because, you know, they would like, this is the touch, it's there in the class. You know, so she was good, very patient with them. And even though she struggled in her studies because her hand is on the weak side, but she never gave up.
Because I'm Indian.
Sometimes she will come to me and say, you know, Siew Yan, today I needed to ask for direction. I walked towards a member of the public and I wanted to ask for direction, but when I walked towards them, they saw me, they ran away, you know. And she felt really hurt.
The first thing that I'm Indian. The children, no one would talk to me. All ran away.
This was Siew May's classroom 24 years ago. And this is the classroom where I met her. She was my geography student in Sec 1G. This was the classroom. Those are sitting arrangement is different now, but this was the room. I think one of the difficulties that Siew May experienced was trying to cope with her studies. Yeah, especially when it comes to writing and also speaking clearly. So it's not so much of her having to cope with this difficulty. It is more like for us to learn how to listen attentively to Siew May.
I feel when you talk to them, even though they run away.
Siew May will always come to me and flash her biggest smile and say, Miss Yu, how are you?
I don't let people see.
So you will go into the chapel?
I'll look for you. You're my angel.
So are you. I can't.
I read the book that night and I couldn't put the book down. I read it continuously and finished it. And the next morning I rang my friend and I said, Michelle, how do I contact May? And she said to me, I knew you'd call me. Because if you read her book, you will find that she was looking for a job, you know, because she was without a job. So she gave me May's number and I phoned May and I visited her at her house. And sort of interviewed her because I like to meet people who I try to help. I like to meet their families.
Yeah, because I'm not disabled. Yeah. But I never give up. I try and I never want to give up because I need to. I'm living. I think nobody will take care of me when I'm old.
We have to adjust the farm entrance in such a way so that May can meet and greet people. And we set up a stall for her, selling our plants and things, but also for her to sell her book.
He never treat me like a disabled. Rather, he treats me like everyone else.
So if you stand at my gate, you will see that the Caucasians can have a fantastic conversation with me. They'll stop for her to explain, oh, you have to pay $2 to get in, etc. Whereas the Asians, most of the Asians who come in, right, will just look at her and then like walk past her, you know, as if though she's not there. And then I can see everything, so I end up coming out again with my wonderful knife, right? And standing there and say, excuse me, did you notice my staff talking to you? Right? And then they realize, oh, you know, then they walk back and then they pay her $2 for the entrance fee, you know? But I find that people can be quite unkind, you know? Like if May's talking to them and they see me, they'll just ignore her and start talking to me. So I'll tell them, excuse me, my staff is talking to you. And please let my staff do her job. Siew May is excellent, you know. She can almost do everything. First of all, she comes all the way from Tampines to work here. So it takes her 2 hours to work and 2 hours to get home. So she commutes for 4 hours. The last part of the journey from the MRT station to here, there is no transport. So we farmers provide her with a bus to come to work. She never misses the bus, right? She's always on time, never misses the bus. She's never been sick. She can do everything, right? She can do everything. And I treat her as if though she's normal, you know? So she greets people, she runs the stalls, she collects money, etc. When it's not crowded outside, she will come inside the restaurant and take orders. She can also take orders. She can also deliver drinks. So she's an excellent person. She can do everything. And I think it's because I don't believe that you have to make excuses for somebody who's disabled, you know. I think you just let them do their best. And I think she has a great influence on the rest of my staff. I think they all learn to be kinder. They learn to be helpful to each other and not complain about each other all the time, because May never complains about anyone or anything, and she will just do her best. And you know, like if we have a big rush of people, you can see her even running, you know, to the counter inside to bring more cakes out to sell and things like that. You know, her complete a desire to do a good job and to do it well has a great influence on all my staff.
With Ali, it really at me that because he loved me a lot, and he always promote my book. I want to write a book because I want to love the people that we disabled are not learning and able.
Before Siew May wrote her book, she actually contacted me and she said, "Miss Yu, I have put together a book. I've spent 2 years putting the draft together." And because I know Siew May's background very well, and I said, "Siew May, when you write this book, you are writing your life story, and that would also be talking about your family and all. Would you be comfortable exposing your family to the public reader?" And I said, "What is your objective of writing the book?" It was a very humbling moment when she shared with me. She said, "Miss Yu, I write this book." And I remember what you said to me. "I write this book because I want to tell the world out there to accept us for who we are. We want to be treated normal. We don't need any special attention." And that was the reason that she wrote this book. And I was very humbled by her objective.
I was very touched. And I said that, "Hey, you know, these stories are really inspiring." And I say that, "Yeah, sounds good." Subsequently, with the help of a few friends, co-writer, editor, some friends who do the book cover, some friends got a publisher, some printer, we managed to put the book together in just under maybe about 4 months.
I made it before, and I thought, but then, because my life at the very top is without all this, my life, I wouldn't get the book out.
I've known Siew May since 2009, when she first contacted us. Back then, we were known as the Spastic Students Association of Singapore. And she told us that she was an old girl from our school, and that she actually wrote a book, Scaling Walls, about her life story and the challenges that she has faced and what she has overcome and what she has achieved since she graduated from our school. And we met up with her and we went through the book and we were very, very impressed with what she has achieved in such a short period of time.
They have a disabled kid, but given a good education and love, they can be somebody that can light up the darkness of the
Siew May makes an annual donation to us from the sales of her books, and we actually started a school education bursary in which whatever donations that she has given us goes into this bursary. And this bursary has helped our school students in our special school age 7 to 18 with their like school fees, uniforms, transport. In whatever areas that they need help, we actually tap on this bursary to actually help them.
She had a very positive thinking, which normally people do not have. And she always challenged herself.
And I will always remember Siew May when she told me that she has climbed Mount Kinabalu. I have attempted climbing Kinabalu. It was very tough. But the fact that she climbed Mount Kinabalu, and I was like, wow, she is good. And she was sharing with me how the guide literally didn't have to do much because Siew May was the inspiration for the rest of the climbers.
We are disabled, but we can be somebody. We are not without. We only stop running, walk running.
Siew May is truly my angel. You know, in everything that we do in life, we always have one or two angels in our life. And I should say she's an angel because, you know, we are always out there encouraging people, but it's always amazing because every time in a time where I need someone there or someone that needs to encourage me, she will appear on a phone, she will send a message, or on a Facebook, she will come around and she will send me encouraging messages. And, you know, I always call her my angel because somehow or other she knows, maybe she's sensitive in a way where she knows my, you know, how I feel at the point of need, and she will always appear, and it's amazing.
To me, it's my dream. My dream is to see that the effort and normal people living happily without any barrier.
Knowing Siew May has helped me to look at, or rather redefine, the meaning of resilience and being an overcomer. It helped me to redefine that, you know, it can be in many contexts, but how do we take it personally? I say, if Siew May can do it, anyone can do it.
I only put money, but look money, but I am normal.
And she wants to give back, especially to the school that she has attended to, which we feel that is, you know, it's very generous of her. She could have just kept the sales proceeds for herself and climbed another mountain. we find that she has a very generous soul.
She's extraordinary at the same time because every time you interact with her, she's such a beautiful person, and you know, you can feel that from her love, from her expression, and there's so much love in her. And you know, and she appreciates life, she appreciates you and who you are as well. And you know, for someone like her, there's so much of her that she's giving up to everybody.
You know, sometimes we face a bit of challenges in life, and then we say, wow, you know, life is so difficult. And we complain, we become complacent. But then again, when I remember all the challenges that Siew May go through, it makes me feel that, you know, I don't have the right to really complain about life because we are healthy, we can get around quite easily, we can communicate with people quite clearly. But for Siew May, it's almost an everyday affair that people look at her with a different eye.
I'm very blessed to have her as a friend. In fact, I tell Siew May, you know, though I was your teacher, but there are times when I said, Siew May, you are my teacher.
Love can great makeup, and if everyone gives a little bit of love to anyone, this world will become that will be hope, and there will be no walls, and I believe it's the compassion. If you're,
'cause I find all I is in you. If I miss the finish line, but to you